It's an early morning. The birds are singing. The sun is shining. The clouds are clear. The farmer gets up and goes to the farm. When the farmer gets to the farm, he finds that the crops have been scorched by the shining sun. What's left is dried up because of lack of rain from the clear skies. And what's left has been gobbled up by the singing birds. This week on Seeds of Gold, we are going to look at greenhousing and drip irrigation as ways of controlling the environment around your crop. Huge investments for even bigger profits on Seeds of Gold. Throughout the Seeds of Gold journey, we have met farmers who use greenhouses for effective farming and better yield. This has ranged from organic farming, horticulture, and many other profitable crops. On this episode, we will take an in-depth look at greenhouses and drip irrigation. Brian.
Yes, Matt.
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
Yes, sir. Tell us a bit about yourself.
I am a 23-year-old Kenyan who founded a company together with my colleague, Titan Etich.
Okay.
We were broke in campus and decided to start farming.
That happens a lot.
A lot.
They broke in campus.
So means, I'm not alone in this.
Yeah, you're uko peke yako for sure.
Thank you. Yes.
And then why farming?
Coming from agricultural families, I'm from Eldoret. My partner is from Kericho. Okay. We had a thing for agriculture.
Mm.
We had seen our parents' farm. We had seen our neighbor's farm. Okay. So we went for something we were comfortable with.
Mm.
Yes.
So what were you studying at the university?
I was doing economics and statistics.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And your partner?
In mechanical engineering.
None of you are doing farming.
I think it's in the blood.
Yes. Farming is in the blood.
It's in the blood.
Okay.
Yes.
So you came up with aluminum greenhouses.
Aluminum greenhouses.
Now, did you find experience in greenhouses with your farming parents, or why did you come up with greenhouses?
No. When we decided to go farming, we decided to go the horticultural way because that's where the money is.
Mm.
So we went down to Loitoktok, decided to lease some land, did tomatoes for a season, but we got some challenges. Because of the rain, we lost everything.
Mm.
So those were our Jumbo Junior savings, literally.
If you would want to, you know, if you can divulge that information, how much was your investment?
About 45,000.
Okay.
Yes.
Broke campus students losing 45,000.
Yes.
Help, Mama Maliza. Yeah. Anyway, go on.
So after that, we saw a challenge. Mm. We decided to shop for greenhouses.
Mm.
Going around, they were damn expensive.
Mm.
Everything over 260,000.
Mm-hmm.
So you have broke guys who are even much more broke,
mm-hmm.
and you're being told to cough out 260,000 for a greenhouse. Mm-hmm.
So when you did tomatoes,
yes.
Is because you had been told that that's where the money is.
Yes. And the good thing with that area, it's the produce is bulked up.
Mm-hmm.
So a truck comes all the way from Nairobi, mm-hmm. they pick the produce, they pay you on the site.
On the site,
yes.
For everything, and then they
yes.
go.
Yes, we actually learned it from a classmate who was doing it.
Mm-hmm.
You're just sleeping in the dorm hostel, mm-hmm. he gets a message, he has 25 Gs and you have 200. You're like, no, I should do something.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. So when mulichomeka kila kitu,
yes.
that's when you realized a better way of doing the tomato farming
yes.
is greenhouses.
Greenhouse.
Yes.
So we go try shopping for greenhouses. It's damn expensive. So we go back to the table. We research on the net. Try to look up designs. What and what. We go home. We ask for one of our folks to give us some tree. We cut it down. Look for a local fundi. Try design something, and we got to bring down the cost about 4 times. So after that, now we got to the agronomic support stage.
Mm.
So we got another guy from around to give us advice, and we did not get that good advice.
Mm.
So we got a bit some profits, but we did not get to the what we had desired.
Mm.
So we saw that there was a problem. Number one, lack of affordable greenhouses.
Mm.
Number two, lack of extension services for the greenhouses constructed.
Mm.
Because farmers were complaining that there is no one to tell me what to plant, when, what chemicals to use.
Mm.
No visits every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, because you need that constant touch.
Support, yes. So that's when you came up with aluminum greenhouses.
Yes.
Why the name aluminum?
We just found it catchy.
Uh-huh.
Yes. It will make you ask that question, and that's better for us.
Hey. Tell us, why greenhouse farming?
Okay, greenhouse farming, for starters, you're able to plant high value produce that fetch better prices. So you're able to do a hybrid tomato Anna F1 that yields up to 15 kgs a plant. So you harvest for a period of 8 months, and it's better for the farmer because it's an investment. You need to get your money back. Secondly, with a controlled environment, you have less pests and diseases. Horticulture is really sensitive, and on that aspect, you need that controlled environment. Yes.
So what's the primary business of Illuminant Greenhouses?
So we construct greenhouses and open field irrigation systems. Let's say you have 5 acres, you want to do drip irrigation, we do that. We also have own greenhouses that we have produce that we sell.
Right.
And then apart from that, we offer agronomic support. You might have your own greenhouse, but you can visit your farm every 2 weeks and give you the advice on what to plant and the chemicals to use. Okay. We also have sensor technology. Yes.
Tell us about that.
So this is a tech aspect of farming. From our experience, the farm is way back down in Kericho.
Okay.
So you have a 2,000 liter tank. 2 days later, you're told maji imeisha. Pump imeharibika. So we got to know that there was a problem in terms of watering. You will tell the guy on the ground, spray this, he will spray that. Do weeding, do pruning, everything. But he doesn't think that water is essential or is that important. So we innovated a system, a farm automation kit that is solar powered, so it works anywhere. It is installed in your greenhouse or your open field irrigation, and you're able to remotely via text message monitor your water. Yes. So you might decide to go for a wedding, and then you forgot to water your plants. Just text water on, it waters. Water off, it closes.
Agri business, agri tech.
Agri tech. Yes.
I want agri money. Now, this particular greenhouse.
Yes.
Is there a reason why you have it here, particularly at this showground venue?
We were showcasing at the Nairobi International Trade Fair.
Yes.
Yes. It was our first time. It was a good experience. Yes.
Can you probably tell us about that?
Yeah, it was really good interacting with farmers. Guys really want to get into agriculture. People are saying, we want our side hustle. Let us not do movies. Let us not do clothes. Let's do agribusiness.
Yes.
Somebody says they have a 2-acre piece of land in Melala to Mbani. My folks want this, yes. So the appetite for agriculture is really growing.
All right, cool. So you are going to show us more as we continue.
Please.
But when we come back, we are going to also interact with Professor Liu from Egerton University on Seeds of Gold.
Greenhouse technology is the technique of providing favorable environmental conditions to the plants from adverse climates such as wind, cold, temperature, insects, and disease. This and more to come after the break. Before the break, we met Brian, a young entrepreneur who specializes in construction of greenhouses and drip irrigation. Joining us in this discussion is Professor Liu from Egerton University.
Professor, welcome.
Good morning, Mr.
Marco. This is Brian
Fly, yes.
With Illuminum Greenhouses. This is Professor Liu from Egerton University.
Okay.
Professor, welcome.
Okay, thank you.
Professor, engage us a bit by first telling us what is a greenhouse.
Yeah, greenhouse is just a structure like this, but should be covered with this transparent material, like polyfilm or glass.
Greenhouses allow you to control temperature and humidity, a manipulation that helps you grow vegetables year-round. This means you can mimic the climate of any section of the world, giving you more control for better crops.
Greenhouse, the most important advantage is it can create a modified microclimate for the plants.
Okay.
So like when the weather is a little bit cold, this can have a little bit warm environment.
Yes.
When outside is raining, the structure can prevent the rain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we are not getting a lot of disease like in the open field.
Mm-hmm.
So even like during rain season, like tomatoes,
mm-hmm.
it will be very difficult to grow outside.
Mm-hmm.
But in greenhouse, we can do it very well.
Besides providing shelter from threatening weather, a greenhouse allows you to minimize the introduction and spreading of disease as you control what goes in and out. Potted plants and drip irrigation is a combination that is sure to give you a good return.
Are there any particular crops that necessarily need greenhouses to be planted in, or you can grow any type of crop?
Generally, any crop can be grown in greenhouse,
mm-hmm.
but it depends on the economic value.
The returns.
Yeah, because the greenhouse, you have to invest in the structure.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to get the return. Even should be much more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so should be valuable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so like the tomatoes, pepper, these ones, they have high value.
I've seen a couple of greenhouses, and particularly with yours, I'm keen to understand. I see your structure is mainly wooden.
Yes.
Is there any particular reason why to have the wooden structure? And is there any advantage of it against the ones that are metallic?
From my experience, the metallic brother to this is much more expensive. 3 times.
Mm-hmm.
So we decided to set out to give smallholder farmers what they can afford.
Mm-hmm.
And once we get to your site, we assess if you have any trees, any posts that we can use, and it brings down the cost by about 40,000.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. To give back to the environment, for every greenhouse we have a policy, we plant 10 trees on our cost.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Professor, when yes. constructing a greenhouse, what are some of the key things that an individual needs to know and put in mind?
The first is the structure.
Mm-hmm.
What type of structure you want?
Okay.
So, like you know, this is a timber greenhouse.
Mm-hmm.
Also, as Mr. Brian said, also we can have a metallic greenhouse.
Mm-hmm.
But the timber greenhouse be the cost be much low.
Yes.
Especially if the family they have some timber.
Yes.
Then they also the land is available. They can build a timber greenhouse very easily.
Okay.
But the issue is when you go for timber greenhouse. You know, there are some like termites.
Yes.
They may eat the timber.
Mm.
If possible, if we can treat
the
timber before you use.
When setting up your greenhouse, make sure it is in a location where it will get direct sunlight. Avoid tall buildings or trees. Ensure the ground is leveled for even water spread, especially in drip irrigation. Treat wood pillars to prevent them from termite attack.
So other than cost, is there any difference between constructing with timber versus constructing with metal?
The first difference is with timber you can play around with the structure.
Mm.
You can get your own piece of land is 2x2
mm.
and actually customize it to that size.
Uh-huh.
Secondly, with timber you get a better clearance. So you do not get to suffocate your plants. There's enough air circulation in the greenhouse.
With the timber.
Yes.
How exactly is that compared to the metallic one?
The metallic. With the timber, you're able to create ventilations on the top.
Mm.
As you can see, we have vents
mm.
on the top and on the top on that side and on that side.
Uh-huh.
We also have a better width to work with on uh-huh. the short and the longer sides.
Okay.
Yeah.
A greenhouse size is usually dictated by factors like available space, construction costs versus need or desire. When choosing a size, consider if the greenhouse will be used year-round or seasonally.
In terms of roofing,
mm.
I've seen different types of greenhouse roofings, you know, just around. I can see this one is Zimenda's.
Yeah, this we call it the A-flint.
Okay.
Like a capital A.
Yes, yes. Capital A, yes. Yes. And then I've seen the...
Another type is the
upside down U.
Yeah, yeah.
Since we are using the alphabet.
We called it Tana.
Yes. And then I've seen others that are also A, but a bit sharper at the top.
Yes.
Do these play any role in the greenhouse effect?
Yeah, the shape of the roof affects the light transmission.
Yes.
So if here the light most of the time is on the top of the roof.
Yeah.
So if the roof is too sharp of light, a lot of light is going to be reflected away.
The shape of a greenhouse roof is important because it affects light reception. A roof with a very sharp edge at the top will tend to bounce off more heat energy.
What are some of the key things to check when you're constructing greenhouse pahali unaishi? Yes.
So for starters, you need to do a site analysis. Mm. So a technician needs to visit your site. Mm. You will say you want a 5x20, but your land is 1x1. So you also need the technician to see, do you want the greenhouse where there's enough light? Mm. How is the wind direction? Mm. How is the gradient, as Professor said? Mm. Are we going to raise the beds? Mm. So after that, the technician will also be able to collect soil samples. Mm-hmm. The soil samples will be taken to lab. Two tests are done. You need to do a mineral and a pathological test. Mm. The mineral test is to give you the right fertilizer program and soil correction program to use for your specific crops. Mm. You need to know how much gypsum, how much urea, everything. Mm. For the pathological, which is really critical, and farmers tend to overlook, you need to know what bacterial or fungal infections are in your soil. Mm. So that you need to know if you need to do the potting or you can do the normal beds. Mm. Yes.
So the testing,
Yes, we do the testing. We have our partners. Mm. Yes.
Okay.
Your greenhouse will work best if you balance the temperature and humidity to favor the crops.
This is where you've stored the water.
Tank, yes.
Okay.
It's 1,000 liters, so you need a water filter so that your drip lines don't get clogged up.
Ah, with the impurities?
Yes, so because water is never that pure.
Yeah.
And then you have algae also, so you need a water filter to filter that out.
All right. Okay.
So this is Paul.
All right.
He's the one who's done this magic.
All right. Yes. How are you, Paul?
I'm good.
Okay.
Yes.
So, talk to us about what is happening here.
Now, this is a drip line. Mm-hmm. We have some crops here. Mm. We have strawberries. Mm-hmm. We have onions.
Wait. Pause there. You have strawberries. Now continue.
We have strawberries. Uh-huh. We have onions. Uh-huh. We have spinach. Mm-hmm. And we have black nightshade, local vegetables. Mm-hmm.
That's managu.
Yes, that is managu.
All right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And all this is under the drip irrigation.
Yes, this is outdoor.
Outdoor open field drip irrigation.
Yes.
Brian, tell us, how big can you go with the drip irrigation?
I think you can go as big as your pocket is, because open field irrigation is cheaper compared to the greenhouse farming, but it depends on the size.
You
have guys doing 2 acres all the way. We have a mnyunyizi, which is a 1 acre. Mm-hmm. We can go as low as a quarter acre, but you have guys going as big as 20, 30 acres. Mm-hmm. So for drip irrigation, you really need to know how your land is in terms of gradient. Secondly, in terms of raising your tank, you need an adequate supply of water. Mm-hmm. Because if you're doing high value produce like you're doing French beans, you need a lot of water. Mm-hmm. So you need maybe a 10,000 liter tank if you're doing 5 acres. Mm-hmm. But you can reduce on the pumping hours. Mm-hmm. And with enough water in the tank, you have enough pressure to feed your drip line.
Okay, is that also the emphasis of the height?
Yes, on the height.
Of the tank?
Yes. If you're doing a 10 acre, it will be much more reasonable for you to raise it maybe 4 or 5 meters high, so that you can feed every single area of your land. Mm-hmm. Secondly, on drip lines, you need to be careful on the drip spacing you choose. Mm-hmm. For example, here we have onions. Onions do well with a 15 centimeter spacing. Mm-hmm. The spacing, this is the aspect of how far the holes are. Mm-hmm. Because you need to maximize the produce. Mm-hmm. You cannot space spinach as farther as
you would space onions.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Also, Professor.
Yes.
What is the advantage then of drip irrigation, especially when it comes to open space?
So the drip irrigation, the water is going to supply to the plants.
Just as we saw in the, greenhouse.
So directly.
Yes.
So the wastage will be very minimal.
Uh-huh.
Then also drip line can also put the fertilizer into the water. Then be supplied to the plants.
So yes, you don't need again to come
and
put fertilizer at a different time.
Yes.
All right. Now, when it comes to products and the market, there is a thing called market timing.
Yes.
Okay. Talk to us about that.
Okay.
And the importance of the farmer to understand market timing.
Okay. Because if you're getting to eat for the money, you really need to know what time to plant.
It's agribusiness. Without the business, then it's agriculture.
True.
Yako tu ya nyumbani.
Equally. Uh-huh. Another thing, you have installed drip lines for the sole purpose of planting when other guys are not planting.
Yes.
So you need to time your produce when other guys who are not using the same drip lines do not have produce for you to get the best price. Then we've also seen a good uptake with contract farming, where guys, you link up a farmer with an exporter, they do French beans, they do a 10 acre piece, they've spaced it up, planted in steps of 1 acre, 1 acre, 1 acre.
So they're able to, 1 acre is ready, yes. nine is getting ready. The next month you have the second acre, yes. Just like that. It's just kind of a time rotation. It's spaced out time.
Yes.
Uh-huh. All right.
Drip irrigation can be done both in the greenhouse and in the open field. The only difference is that the success rate is higher in a greenhouse because it's a controlled environment.
With drip irrigation on, say, a piece of land that is, as you'd mentioned, also as big as 20 acres or 30 acres, does that mean you'll need to have at least different, you know, many tanks placed strategically, at least to also help with the pressure, or just one big one will be able to?
Depending on the orientation of the land, you'll need to divide it. It actually depends on how the land slopes. So maybe you'll divide it into blocks. And then another major aspect is, how are you spacing your planting? Because another thing, we're looking at the market. You don't want to harvest everything at the same day.
True.
Yes.
All right.
So you'll want to maybe section it into, maybe a 20 acre will section it into four sections, five. Each section has its own tank. Yes.
All right, okay. How much would I need, say, per quarter of an acre or per acre or whatever math there is, how much would I need for a drip irrigation system?
Okay, for starters, you will have to work backwards. Where is your farm? It's in Thika, right? It's in Kisumu, it's in Siaya, it's in wherever. What market do you have? Do you have guys who will appreciate greenhouse tomatoes? Will have guys who will say, no, I don't want that. Because greenhouse tomatoes are supposed to sell higher
than open field tomatoes. Okay.
So work with the market you have. Do you have a market that will appreciate onions better? So from there now, we'll decide on which investment you're going to go for. If you go for 1 acre, we will use a drip irrigation, complete irrigation of the water tank. It's about 120,000. And then you can also start with a smaller greenhouse, which is a kadogo, which is 6 meters by 20. It's about 130. So the math is almost, we tried packaging it to the level where the farmer has the option of going either with the investment they have. But the main thing is the market. What market do you have?
Okay.
Yes.
All right. So is there a special drip irrigation package?
We customize it depending on the client's needs. So you will, maybe you'll want the small type. We have the narrow, the different millimeter gauges for the drip line. This is a 16 millimeter. And as I said, we have different spacings. Yes.
Okay.
Remember, when purchasing your drip irrigation kit, spacing of the crops is done according to the size of the drip. More to come after the break. We head out to Kajiado County to meet a farmer who lives in an area with major water challenges. Despite this, she has boldly ventured into greenhouse farming and has just completed her first harvest.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Martin?
Elizabeth?
Yes.
Yes. Umerudi.
Karibuni sana.
Yes.
Hello.
So Elizabeth, you farm using a greenhouse.
Yes.
Yeah. Probably you can show us around.
Yes, you can.
Hi.
Please welcome.
Asante.
Elizabeth has invested in a metallic greenhouse. Although slightly higher in price, metallic structures last longer, are easier to maintain, and are easier to assemble.
So we are in a metallic greenhouse.
Yes.
Not really that it is metallic. It's just that
it's mainly made of glass.
The structure is metallic.
Yes.
Like, how much did it cost to have this one?
So this is an 8x15. As you can see, it's metallic because of the structure itself.
Yeah.
So we have polythene on the top, but on the side, because of the heat, we have used insect netting. It's really hot, and there's some guys who, you have farmers who have less produce because of suffocating the plant. Yes, a greenhouse needs enough air circulation.
Aeration.
Yeah. Mm. So you need to know the region you're growing for you to modify your greenhouse.
Mm. Yes. Okay. So the netting, is that applicable even in other areas, or is it just because
you might get an area like Nanyuki that is really hot during the day and really cold during the night. Mm-hmm. So we'll need to have the net during the day, then have a roll up that during the night you can close, you can shut down the roll it down, and so you can make it warmer during the night.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So does the metal structure have also any role in the heat?
None whatsoever.
Uh-huh. Professor, we were in a timber structure greenhouse. Now we are in a metallic structure greenhouse.
Yes.
Differences other than just the materials.
You know, the metallic fluents are strong.
Yes.
So you can see it doesn't need to have a lot of materials.
And it does not have a lot of support.
You can see in that greenhouse, it's very really dark because of a lot of fluents. So block the light.
Yes.
Here you can see just a few pieces of limbs.
Yeah.
The light transmission is much better.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Any particular metal for the
frame? There are different metals in the market. Some are black French pipes.
Mm-hmm.
Like this is good. This is galvanized.
Mm-hmm.
So it can last for
much longer.
Period. It will not get to last easily.
Okay. Yes. Now what about the polythene bag? The one that usually has sugar, is that the one I can come buy rolls and rolls of them and then put on my greenhouse?
Yes, the polyfill for greenhouse also come in laws, but it is a specific type.
Which particular?
So the greenhouse polyfill requires first should be anti-drip. The normal polyfill, if we cover greenhouse, during the night we form some dew.
Yes.
Then the dew will drip to the
plants. Drop to the plants.
They cause diseases.
Yes.
But as greenhouse covering material, should not have that dew.
Uh-huh.
Yes. So we call it anti-drip.
Mm-hmm.
Then the second is we put this polyfill under sunlight.
Mm-hmm.
Sunlight can degrade the normal polyfill
the material,
easily.
Yeah.
So this one should be UV treated.
Mm-hmm.
Under strong UV light, it can still last for a longer period.
Uh-huh. What made you decide on greenhouses?
Okay, first of all, as you can see, the buses me aripu hiyo gate yangu. That's what we used to be. Ukipanda hapa, zinaingia, zinakula.
On open field, the goats would come and just finish everything.
When we move a little bit, everything is done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Sasa nanojua tuko area Masai.
Mm-hmm.
They have to just continue taking care of their livestock.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So now I'm descendant. Mm-hmm. I have to just cover it up,
okay.
Then just farming inside the greenhouse.
Mm.
But I was very confused because I didn't know how to start off everything.
So how did you know about greenhouses?
Okay, Ken, there's a neighbor, man Ken.
Mm.
He just convinced me that he does greenhouse business.
Mm.
And he told me I wanted to get at it because when you compared about the timber and this metallic greenhouse, the timber was a bit, it wasn't that much expensive, but on the other side, they can just get rotten everything.
The durability.
The durability is very strong.
Yeah.
So I just went on for the greenhouse with this metallic.
So for you, the durability was a factor, big factor that made you decide that this is...
Because I didn't want another mess because of the structure.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So far, how has it been?
It has been good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No regrets.
No regrets.
So Kian has kept his promise.
Yes, he has.
No regrets.
He really has.
Ah,
yes.
Right. Okay. So this is also an advantage of this kind of greenhouse because of the water harvesting. Gutters.
Yes, yes. You need to harvest your water because it's really crucial for you to manage your water.
Mm.
But as you had seen the previous site, with the double A, as Professor said, you're able to have another gutter at the middle. So with the wooden, there's a slight advantage that you can harvest more water.
Uh-huh.
Yes. You harvest both in the sides and the middle.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
For how long then have you been with this greenhouse?
That in 2014, that's when we planted. Mm. This was the first harvest.
Okay.
Yes.
So when, what exactly did you plant? Was it only tomatoes?
It was tomatoes and retro spinach.
Throughout the period from when you started planting till now, what are some of the challenges that you faced?
Okay, maybe sometimes it's raining, and the crops want water, and you have to go and fetch water. The round day Monday, you can't pass. You have to wait until it's dry.
Black cotton clay soil.
Yes. So that's a big challenge. When it's raining, and the one you are harvesting, at that moment it's very little because that keep you a lot of the bigger container and the dancers. So the big one is at the top. Now you have to just keep on fetching from the small one, going to the top one.
Because the top one is the one also connected to the drip system.
The drips, yes. Because the small one is not connecting the drips.
Yes.
And you need it to be at the top because of the pressure.
Yes.
You can't connect the drips when it is done.
Yeah.
That's a big challenge. Yes.
All right. Thank you very much, Elizabeth.
Yeah.
Hopefully next time to Rudy to party a pili hapo.
That's a must. That's a promise. I promise.
Thank you very much, Professor, for being with us.
Thank you.
This gentleman has over 18 years of experience in Kenya.
Even in greenhouse farming, support from both agronomists and extension officers is important. We head out to meet Ken, who offers farmers such support.
Ha! One. Ken!
Yep.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Hapa mvua itaingia?
Hapa haiwezi ingia kwa sababu imefunikwa vizuri. Kuna hii polythene imezuia hata kukinyesha mvua ya mawe haiwezi mvua ingia hapa ndani.
All right. Tell us, kwanza nimekusikia sana. Anything Brian tunataja ya Illuminium anasema Ken can. You know. So tell us a bit about yourself.
My name is Kenneth Isinjiro, and I'm an agronomist by profession. When I talk about agronomist, it's a very big name, lakini kwa kulima huwa tunaambiwa mimi ni daktari wa mimea.
An agronomist is a crop doctor concerned with the health and well-being of crops used for food production.
We don't like whereby we do a greenhouse.
Yes.
And then mkulima ameweka hapo kitu ajui atauza wapi,
atapeleka
wapi hiyo kitu inakaa aje itafanya nini. So we also make sure that after doing this we have to make sure that our farmers are also benefiting. So by doing that we do the follow-ups by providing the agronomic support. So that's whereby we are directing them. Wanajua kama kupea mumea ikianza kuleta shida itakula itapata nini itaendelea aje ndio sasa mazao yake ikue vile tunatarajia.
All right, right. And sasa this is one of the this greenhouse is one that was constructed by Illuminium Greenhouses.
Yeah.
So this farmer is getting some of the benefits that Illuminium Greenhouses provides.
Yeah. And this is a farmer who took our services. Both the agronomic support and the construction. So we've been with this farmer. This is the seventh month.
Yes.
So we've been harvesting this tomato. We've been harvesting for 4 months. So tumekuwa na yeye. All over after 3 months we still converse on the phone. Akitupigia simu, we can also pass around.
Okay.
Yeah. So we still advise our farmers.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Brian.
Yes.
So far, what has been the response of farmers as far as the engagement between Illuminium Greenhouses and farmers is concerned?
I think it's been really good. And with Illuminium, we try to change the payment as much as possible to fit your farmer.
Okay.
If you cannot afford the bulk agronomic support, we have a pay-as-you-go basis. So if you do less visits, if you have less visits, you pay less. And then we just subsidize it. We just see how we can work it out.
What's the vision for Illuminium Greenhouses? You have been like here.
Illuminium seeks to provide endless market for our farmers, whereby you get our greenhouse or you get our drip irrigation, we will assure you that we will export it and we will eliminate the broker in reality. Yes.
Okay. I'm sure farmers come to you at times with very many problems, you know, there is this issue and that. So which are some of the most common or the most critical that you can point out? Just a quick summary.
Okay. Most of the farmers have been having a problem with the insects. Okay, especially there was a new insect called Tutor solita. It was a really big problem to farmers. But right now, with the interactions and all the measures we've been taking, now farmers are now comfortable, they don't have a problem. But the other issue is the white flies. Mm-hmm. The white flies is also a problem to many farmers.
And especially for the tomatoes.
For tomatoes. And you realize many farmers who treat tomatoes, most of them don't know how to control white flies. Mm-hmm. So we've been advising them as we go around on how to make sure that you will avoid the breeding of white flies. So you have like to keep the greenhouse green. Like you can see this greenhouse, it has been pruned.
Yes.
Then the crops have been lowered. So there is no congestion. So white flies will only feed where there is a lot of bushy and everything. So we go on as we on our trainings. We also advise farmers on the ways they'll do to prevent these white flies. So, but the other diseases, they can be prevented. We just advise them to go for fungicide and insecticide.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Thank you very much, Ken. Thank you very much, and good job with Illuminum Greenhouses.
Thank you.
And Brian, again.
Thank you.
Asante sana.
Karibu, karibu.
Tutazidi.
Sawa. Tutazidi. Make sure you have something for your family.
If you insist.
Please.
I will not refuse.
Sawa.
I will not. All right. There we have it. Again, we say knowledge is power. Information is key. This is Seeds of Gold.
The KCB Foundation is doing many programs, and one of our core programs is Mifugo Ni Mali, which is a livestock value chain development program. And we are here in the expo supporting it, participating, and looking forward to outcomes from this expo to not only our programs, but also our farmers groups who are participating. This expo is possible through a partnership, and the KCB Foundation has partnered with AgriPro Focus, Kenya Livestock Marketing Council, SNV, and then there is the University of Nairobi, the Ministry of Agriculture, the Department of Livestock Production, and the Kenya Markets Trust. We are the partners who have come together to organize this expo for the benefit of the farmers in the extensive livestock production system, which is what happens mainly in the arid and semi-arid areas. The most important thing, and which we have been doing in our Mifugo Ni Mali program, is ensuring a farmer is in a cooperative. Because we realized to be rich individually is very difficult. It's difficult for an organization, for the government. No one has the resources to reach you individually. So once you're in a cooperative, and the cooperative has communication networks, then it becomes so much more easy to bring farmers here, because all you need to do is to have liaison with the cooperatives and they're able to bring members. So that's why our programs, the first core program we do in our program is to ensure farmers are enrolled into cooperatives. And that also helps them in terms of financial inclusion, because you remember a lot of farmers have failed to access credit because they don't have any records of what they have been doing. What we need right now is for farmers to have their records and records in cooperatives, because those ones ensure that you are bankable in any financial institution.
Tuko hapa kwa washa hii kuonyesha asali na kuuza, na sisi natoka Mokotio South County, Baringo County. Kikundi chetu iko na wanachama 72. Tulianza kama kikundi cha kujisaidia Selevel Group mwaka wa 96. Karibu miaka 20 iliyopita. Lakini mwaka hii mwezi wa pili tukajiunga tukaregister kama cooperative society. Baada hayo tukapata partners wetu. Mmoja wao ni KCB Foundation, wakatupatia elimu. Baada mafundisho tukaomba hiyo msaada. Na tulipatiwa kufaidika kupata milioni moja na nusu. Tunafurahi sana na KCB na waizani wengine kwa kutuunga mkono. Hasa sisi Rachemo, Ani Marketing Cooperative Society.
Mi naitwa Silas Chebon, kutoka Mokoso Work Peakkeepers Cooperative Society Limited. A society that was started in 1973, and it operated well. After some time, it went down, around 1990s. Until 2010, when the government, through the Ministry of Cooperative Development, and assisted the society to develop a business plan after a feasibility study. The recommendations in that report were used to implement the revival process. We are happy that One of the partners that assisted us is KCB Foundation. When the Commercial Bank Foundation came in and trained us also and facilitated us with startup capital of 500,000, which has now assisted us to jumpstart, and we've started. This is the product that we developed from the money that was given to us. So now we are planning to diversify so that we also incorporate livestock. We are happy that there is Mifuko Nimali program, and we will partner so that we can also have livestock project and as well as fee project.
As we go, we are learning a lot. We are learning at better ways of engaging farmers. We are trying to integrate technology in the way we are going to work with farmers. And most importantly, one of the challenges we have seen in the livestock keeping sector, there needs to be more youth engagement. There are so many opportunities across the livestock value chain that the producer level is just one of the many areas they can play in. So I think it's about time we also opened up our minds when we talk about farming, what it means. You don't need to be a producer to be in the sector. You can play in very many areas. And nowadays, financial institutions are very open to financing across the value chain, not only at the production level. Our parting shot is to encourage the many potential farmers, people who are struggling and wanting to get into the sector, to be more open to the opportunities across various agriculture value chains, not only livestock, even crop. There are many areas you can participate in actively and make a lot of money. So we need not all be fighting for the shambas, for the land, for the animals. There are many ways we can make the money. And so we would encourage all the people who are interested, find out more about which area in the value chain you can actively play in. Importantly, ensure you're in a cooperative or a collective. It helps you in bargaining for inputs and controlling the market. And then you can visit any KCB branch if you require any financing, because there are financial products that are available for actors across the entire value chain.